Very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us in celebrating the release of 175th edition of Precinct's e-magazine that has been proving 16 years of excellence in the field of digital journalism, emphasizing on positive journalism. The masterhead behind this monumental success is Primepoint Srinivasan, who has absorbed the teaching and guidance of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam in the best possible manner. This prestigious e-zine has attained extensive circulation and has organically expanded its readership base with mere quality content, neutrality in views, and its commitment in continuation. This magazine is completely volunteer-based with no commercial attachments ever since its inception. May the skies fall or the oceans dry, our magazine has been reaching you with uncompromised content on every first of the month. And here we are celebrating the 175th. May I request Sri Primepoint Srinivasan, managing editor, publisher and managing editor of Precinct, to deliver welcome.
Good evening and welcome to all chief guests and participants. Before I start my welcome speech, I would like to greet Mr. K.G. Suresh, Professor K.G. Suresh, Vice Chancellor of Makhanlal Chaturvedi, National University of Journalism and Communication, Chief Guest. Happy birthday. May God bless him and his family for all prosperity and let him live a long life to serve the nation and to serve the journalism community. As Priya has introduced, we started way back in March 2006, this particular e-magazine on the suggestion of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, only for positive journalism. We know how much of difficult it is to run a journal, that too on a voluntary basis, without commercial motive, for 16 years, and providing rich articles. Now we have reached 175th edition, and we are proud to present and dedicated to our readers. And shortly, Mr. K.G. Suresh will be relaunching the 175th edition and also the digest of all articles published in the 175 editions in 8 volumes. We have 8 volumes, and the 8 volumes are classified based on the subjects. And Priya will be explaining at the time of the launch. And really, I'm happy that all of you have agreed to join us today. And Professor K.G. Suresh is a very well-known journalist at Delhi. He was working in PTI and he was Director General of Indian Institute of Mass Communication. And presently, he is heading as a Vice Chancellor of one of the ancient or the largest journalism university. In fact, we are very proud to have him here to launch this. And Mr. B.S. Raghavan, another very senior, 90 plus, he is still active in columns and he is also a journalist himself. And he has been working with Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He is one of the oldest surviving IAS officers in the country. He has worked with Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Lal Bahadur Shastri, Indira Gandhi and Morarji Desai. He was also the National Integration, one of the founders of National Integration Council, for which Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was the chairman and he was the secretary, opening secretary, founder secretary. And we are, he was in the United Nations as a policy advisor. And we have Mr. M.B. Jairam and the chairman emeritus of Public Relations Council of India and one of the leading public relations bodies. And we have Mr. Narendra. He is one of the founders of Primepoint Foundation and my guru, and who has been guiding me on all journalism. He is not only a guru for me, he is a guru for many of the communication professionals in this country. And he is the former information advisor to 4 prime ministers. And we are all very happy to have a galaxy of eminent personalities as a chief guest. And we have an editorial team of eminent personalities, academicians, professionals, lawyers, chartered accountants, and everybody. Now I will hand over to Priya to take the session on. Thank you very much and welcome you all.
Thank you so much for a very candid welcome. May I request Professor K.G. Suresh, Vice Chancellor, Makhanlal Chaturvedi National University of Journalism and Communication, Bhopal, which is Asia's largest and India's most respected university for journalism, to launch the 175th edition of Presense e-magazine.
Thank you so much. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It gives me immense pleasure and a sense of pride to launch one of the most prestigious digital journals in this country, and the 175th edition, and the digest of the published articles of Presense 175 in 8 volumes. Today, that is the great occasion. My compliments to Mr. Srinivasan and the entire team. And I'm really honored to be in the august company of Sri Narendra, Sri M.B. Jairam, and Sri Raghavan. I look forward to a closer association with Prime Point and the e-Zine, which I believe that the students and scholars of Asia's first university of journalism, the Makhanlal Chaturvedi University, should be well acquainted with. Because in at a time when we are talking about, of course, I'll come to my address later, but I think this is the formal occasion, so maybe for a later time. But yes, it gives me immense pleasure to launch the 175th edition of Presense.
Srini, put the screenshot.
So
this is 175th edition.
Yes.
This is the 175th edition of Presense. Thank you so much.
And that is Prince. Is that Prince?
Yes. Our cartoon character, Trebal Sharma, also is here. Yes. He is the father of the Prince.
I know. I have welcomed Mr. Trayambak Sharma at my home in Bhopal. Yes.
He is the creator.
Yes.
Next to that, Srini, next.
May I request you, sir, to please symbolically release 8 volumes of digest of select articles published by Presense since its inception. The titles are Indian Heritage, Spotlight on History, Media and Communication, Politics and Governance, Prince Cartoon Collections, Science and Technology, Health, General and Exclusives. So these are the best digest which we have launched along with the 175th edition of Presense. Thank you so much, Professor. Thank you so much for that. May I request Sri S. Narendra, former information advisor to 4 Prime Ministers of India and the founding trustee of Prime Point Foundation, to honor the extraordinary work and volunteership shown by the senior editorial members who have been pivotal in running the show of Presense today. Narendra, sir? Yes.
Namaskaram.
So,
good evening, sir. Audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Well, it gives me immense pleasure that I'm participating in this occasion along with Mr. Prime Point Srinivasan, Mr. K.G. Suresh, Mr. Raghavan, Mr. Padmanabhan, Mr. M.B. Jairam, and others. I know the amount of effort and dedication that gone into the evolution of this pioneer e-journal, I must say. In fact, Prime Point Srinivasan has been a pioneer in podcasts and in starting an e-journal and running it consistently for the last 15 plus years. Running a daily newspaper is different, but running a periodical with the right kind of content to attract audience is an extraordinary job. My compliment goes to the entire team led by Ms. Srinivasan for making this journal such a success. This is another effort that he has undertaken today. Is very often a journal after the red goes into history. By breaking that into subject-wise editions, it is an extraordinary effort. It will be very, very useful for all those, including me, who are students of communication. Initially, I started this as a journal for PR and communication and has expanded it, the scope of this journal, into relevant positive journalism, which is very rare to find these days. My compliments go to everyone involved in this, and I hope with the launch of this and separate editions subject-wise, the e-magazine started by PR Point will continue to have a large audience. These are very, very important, relevant articles, and I hope everyone who is involved in communication and current affairs and positive journalism.
Take the privilege of introducing the team whom we have recognized for the work which they have rendered for the past 16 years in running the show, sir. To begin with is Ms. Susan Koshy, former editor-in-chief Presense and the former general manager of IDBI Bank. Susan, ma'am, can you please unmute your mic?
Yes.
Ma'am,
screenshot. Sir, Narendra, sir, can you just mention?
Ms. Susan Koshy, you have been one of the pillars of PR Sense and it is a highly commendable effort. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Very well deserved appreciation certificate. Thank you.
Mr. V. Rajendran, former editor, former banker, and a cyber law expert.
Thank you.
Mr. Rajendran, I know we have met several times in Chennai, and it is, again, very commendable effort, and a richly deserved appreciation certificate comes to you, and my salutes to you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Triambak Sharma, cartoon editor, Presense, and editor of Cartoon Watch, the only cartoon magazine in India.
Mr. Triambak Sharma, congratulations. Your prints and consistent portrayal of your cartoons in the e-magazine has added value to the magazine. Thank you very much.
Mr. T. N. Ashok, consulting editor, Presense, former editor, and a freelance journalist for national and international papers and magazines.
Well, Mr. Ashok is a many-sided personality. I don't know him at all because we have never met. I hope that is true. And thank you very much for joining efforts in launching this journal and in continuing to provide very good content.
Professor Dr. R. Jagannathan, editorial advisor, Presense, and provost, St. Teresa University, West Indies.
Mr. Jagannathan, my respectful regards to you. Your learned guidance has helped this journal a great deal. Thank you.
Professor Sudarshan Padmanabhan, editorial advisor, Presense, and associate professor at IIT Madras.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Padmanabhan, congratulations. Please continue to associate yourself with journals and let us look forward to its greater success.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Narendra, sir. We would look forward to hearing your presidential address just after hearing Susan, ma'am, on with us right now. So may I request Ms. Susan Koshy, former editor-in-chief, Presense, to share her experience with this e-zine.
Thank you, Priya. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. My association with the e-magazine began in the year 2009. When I moved into Chennai, and my acquaintance with Prime Point Srinivasan was revived. I was first introduced to Srinivasan in the late 1990s at an event which I attended while I was still working with IDBI. Just as I rose from the ranks to the senior position in my career, I rose from the ranks in the editorial team of Presets. I was first informally associated with the e-magazine, which Srinivasan used to share with me. Then with time, as I participated more actively in the preparation of the e-magazine, I was inducted as a committee member before climbing the ladder to finally be the editor-in-chief. And it was an interesting journey for me as part of the team and the e-magazine. The attributes I associate with Presense are, one, passion. Those who wrote for it wrote on issues close to the heart, while ensuring they were relevant to the time and catering to the assorted interests of the readers. Two, credibility. Thanks to the commitment of the team, Presense enjoyed the approval of late Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam as its regular reader and critic. For me, that itself was added motivation to put my best in my writing and preparation of the e-magazine. Every article that was written was prepared with zealous research by its writers. Three, a balanced presentation of the contents in every article, tipping on positive outlook. Every critical analysis was examined for a correct portrayal of the facts and opinions. The focus of Presense was for fair, unbiased reading, incorporating information that is not always common knowledge or popularly known. In the course of this pursuit, we have published articles that have been valued as study material. And number four, assorted topics. Presense endeavored to reach out to the different interests in readers. Therefore, Presense had themes as current affairs that had more in them than what was covered in the dailies, history and ancient culture, especially Indian, global topics of interest, astronomy, environment, health, unsung heroes, and so on and so forth. The release of the 8 volumes of Presense articles that are categorized theme-wise is proof of this. Personally, I enjoyed my working with Presense because writing is of immense interest to me. The writers had the freedom to choose what to write on, as long as they respected the sentiments of the readers, was fair and balanced, and conveyed in the simplest of expressions so as to reach out to the simplest of readers. The greatest challenge I faced every month was mustering up topics and articles. Here again, the team under the helm of the publisher and managing editor Srinivasan discussed, debated, shortlisted, and decided on the topics, the themes, the writers, and the deadlines. And it is a matter of satisfaction that we did it successfully every month so that the issue was released on time every time. In conclusion, I quote the English poet Lord Alfred Tennyson, who said, "The old order changes, yielding place to new, lest one good custom should corrupt the world." However good a practice is, there should always be scope for review and change, preferably for the better. And so, after over a decade of active and fruitful association with Presense, a couple of the old guards in the team have made way for change of guard. I'm proud to say I'm one of them. I left with gratitude, fond memories, and a great experience. I congratulate Srinivasan and his team on the special occasion of the release of the 175th edition and wish many more successful landmarks. With Prime Point Srinivasan as the fulcrum and the constant, such successful landmarks will recur for sure. Thank you.
Thank you so much for such wonderful talk of yours, ma'am. Really, I can completely relate it to you through heart. Your commitment and contribution to Presense is unmatchable, and we're still struggling, the younger team is still struggling to catch up to the pace and the integrity that you have dropped in with Presense. Thank you so much for taking us to such a laurel. Thank you so much for your time.